And people say, you can't do things like that. And I say, yes, you can. You can get a bucket like this, and you can get a blue tack on one side and blue tack on the other, and it won't leak. And it just won't leak, full stop, for months, you know, if not years, if you do it right the first time. So, you know, we've got this, well, 2-inch sort of hole. You put your blue tack on one side, like that. Get it nice and pushed down like that. And then you put your blue tack on the other side and they'll meet, sort of thing, you know. And, you know, you do it fairly quickly. Maybe this should go on the inside, but anyway, what the heck. And you just do the same again, and they'll join and meet up, and slowly, you know, you knead it, sort of thing, and to it. Sometimes you can put your hand on the other side, and I'm just trying to do it one-handedly rather than left club-footedly. So, and we'll do it like that. And you know, just spread it out as you do like this, and then you do the same on the inside, and eventually you've got something that will be waterproof. And people say, oh, you can't do that. And I say, yes, you can. And they say, how did you do that? And I just say, skill. Because what I'm going to do is, that's all you basically have to do. And that's about it, really. I don't have to do too much more on that side. Do the same on this side. Get it to the same sort of... And it can even help. It will even help it stick down. I'm all night seeing macro at the moment because it's getting a bit dark. We're nearly at 8:30 and we haven't quite got to the... when we get to the third week of February, I don't have to worry too much about it, because the sun doesn't set until about 8:45 then on daylight saving time. But there you go. I think that's about it, really. That should hold the water. I suppose there's one way to find out whether it's going to hold the water once we get it off, is to fill it up with water. Because the reason I'm doing this of course, because I want to see whether this will, you know, I'm going to float this in there, and I didn't really want to use the black bucket because I thought it might get a little bit too hot, although it would be nice. So, well, that certainly seems to float quite reasonably evenly. You know, it's not going to tip over or anything like that. So once we've got the peat on, it should be hunky-dory. So, okay, well, we'll leave that out because we've got to put the... Once this is cooled down, well, actually, I might leave it in there because that will help it cool down. But I really want to let it cool down naturally. So, though things do cool down much faster if you leave them in a bucket of water to, you know, float around. As long as they're floating, they'll... Yeah, so anyway, once that's done, I'll set that up and set it out there, and you know, set it out over there, and we'll have a look at it tomorrow. Okay, over and out.